It's Madden NFL 24, and we've got a showcase of shutdown defenses. It's the Texans and the Panthers, and it comes your way next.
The Carolina rains have arrived as we are inside a soggy Bank of America Stadium in Charlotte. Today we've got a Week 8 matchup on tap here, as it'll be the Houston Texans taking on the Carolina Panthers. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and Charles, we look at this Panther ball club as they interplay here. Lurching closer toward the midway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. To return it, Darius Phillips. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. So here are the Texans now. Quarterback, the second overall pick from Ohio State, C.J. Stroud.
And you've got to think that they've got to be feeling pretty fresh. You know, coming off of the open week, didn't have to play, right? Gives them a chance to rest up a little bit, heal some of those aches and pains, and excited about playing again. That really rekindles things a little bit. I want to see how they come out and establish themselves here early.
And that bye week coming right where they want it, in the middle of the schedule. Throwing on second and long. Stroud, he'll get the hook up there to Woods. So just 3 yards on the completion there. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. Stroud. And that's going to be incomplete.
Something we've got to watch in this one. Got to be effective on the passing downs. That's a pretty good first step right there.
On is the punter, Johnston, now as he sends this one away. And here comes Westbrook. 43-yard punt, but they get 9 back on the return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10.
So here are the Panthers set to take over for the first time. And Charles will get a look at the much-heralded rookie Bryce Young, the first overall pick from April's draft.
Young now on first down.
So no advantage in this game for either quarterback in terms of coming off that open week, huh?
Yeah, they both had buys.
Both had them, so you got to figure both of them went back, watched some extra tape, polished up their game, checked out their fundamentals, but they also both had an extra week to prepare for each other's defenses. This could be a whole lot of fun.
Under pressure, they got him again. Corey Littleton. He's the one that drops him this go-around, and that pass rush getting strong here. Back-to-back sacks. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He'll find his man, Terrace Marshall, complete. An incredible play there. They do get big yardage, but they're still stopped a yard or two short, and it's fourth down. They'll try and run for it. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on fourth. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Oh, nice move. Down the left sideline. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. A big play there. With his fourth rushing touchdown on the year. And the Panthers get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. The point after through the raindrops, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. So now we get set to see Houston for their second drive of the ball game.
They were winners the last time they took the field, which was 2 weeks ago. They had the open week last week, so this is a squad that should be really refreshed and ready to roll.
I would agree, because when you get that open week after a victory, it does wonders for everyone. Obviously, your body get a chance to heal up, but your mind as well. You feel good about winning, so now you can get away from it for a few days, put down the playbook, you know, turn off the film. Just be you. Enjoy that time away, and then you come back ready to go.
And Pierce gets it again on second down.
Takes this to the 27, giving 4 yards.
You look at this Carolina defense.
And they're a tough unit to throw against. Currently fourth toughest in the NFL.
And when you see a ranking like number 4 in the league against the pass, that's a testament to both their defensive coordinator and the general.
Toward the sideline, intercepted. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And the Panthers are in great shape here as they take over at the 46-yard line.
Well, it certainly felt like he was going to challenge this defense no matter what, and he stepped up and tried to throw it to the outermost edge of the zone coverage, and they were more than ready for him. The problem now is if they are limited in what they're doing throwing the football, they got to figure out how to move it without being able to throw it to the outside and throw it downfield.
52 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start.
It's Young off play action, rolling to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And this is caught inside the 5. A big play there for Carolina. 37 yards. That's evidence of why you spend a high draft pick on a receiver, isn't it, Charles?
It certainly is. His ability to make plays like that, and we've seen flashes of it from him so far in his rookie season. But also, it opens things up for the rest of the offense because it...
Under pressure now, and he's going to go down just inside the 5-yard line.
Will Anderson in there for the sack on what will be the final play of this first quarter. Second quarter now from Charlotte, and it's the Panthers with the football. Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line, second and goal. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. A great effort there. With his second TD of the game, his 6th on the year. And the Panthers have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Extra point good by Prater, and that'll make the score 14-0. And after the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. Phillips, he's not going to bring this one out, so they will begin the drive at the 25.
Now the Texans offense, they head back out to do battle here. And this not an easy situation. You're down early, in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness, maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3.
Now Stroud. That one complete. It's Tank Dell.
Breaks through the contact. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
22 yards on the catch and run. A first down. Pierce takes it straight ahead.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
And tackled down after a gain of 3, leaves him with 1 yard to go on 3rd down.
Heavy set out there on 3rd and 1. And Stroud now to throw. Going quickly there, but it's incomplete.
Strong coverage by Carolina, and on we go to 4th down. And this will be a long field goal. The skies were clear, but here in the rain and the elements, they'll go for it on 4th. Flag comes in. This might be a free play. And that is incomplete, but there is a flag. And on 4th down, this is a big call. And that one was
was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Stroud to the air on first and 10. Quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete.
This defense is going to have to finish the job. There's still a second half that they have to play. But so far, an absolute total effort. They've disrupted the passing game, stressed the pocket for the quarterback. They forced him into errant throws. Everything they're doing has been executed well.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
That was not a real confident throw right there, and it's just 2 of 7 to start the game. Now he's going to have to find a groove with a big third down coming up. Let's see if his confidence can increase.
Oh, everything falling apart now. Another one intercepted. And the Panthers force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Young now. Flush to his right. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. First down, a 16-yard gain.
We both know there's a lot to win in the way they made it the first round pick this year. Part of it was what they saw in college, his playmaking ability when things break down. As soon as he saw he wasn't getting a lane to throw, he pivoted and found an alternate way to the marker.
Here's a run on first down that won't even get back to the line of scrimmage. He will lose a yard, second and 11. They'll try to throw down. Young. And that is incomplete.
Well, that's a defensive coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
Young on third down. He'll air one out deep for Mingo. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. On fourth down, Matt Ariza sent on to punt. Their quarterback in this offense heading back out to the field. And he's had his struggles here early with a couple of interceptions as he'll try to refocus with a first and 10 to start this drive.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. So the completion good for 6 yards, and it'll be second down.
2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing.
Coming up at halftime, we remind you once again that we're going to check in with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL as we reach now, hard to believe, the halfway point of the season. Time flying.
It certainly is. Time to get the sweaters out, my man.
First down now, but that clock rolling. Here's Stroud. His throw incomplete.
This is a half where not just the coverage, but the entire defense is setting the tone in this game.
18 Rattler. Stroud out of the gun here. Quick slant here to Woods. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Now here's Stroud on third down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he won't get close. Only a yard. 4th and 3. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away.
On that punt, we've got a man shaken up. But the medical staff is going to come out here and take a look, and we will take a short break.
Here we go. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10.
Drill, 52.
Young. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's 2nd down.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got 2nd and 3rd down to fall back on.
Young to throw again on 2nd and 10. Under pressure.
pressure, and the Texans able to get in there for the sack.
Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
He rifles one, and it's going to be intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick, and the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line.
First and 10, it's Stroud.
And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40.
Stroud getting his offense to the line quickly.
Second and long. Throw left side complete. That's back. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime.
Throwing now is Stroud.
Blitz coming, and down he goes.
Not the first and goal play they drew up. Multiple defenders in to bring him down to the ground.
Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long.
Stroud to throw it.
Got a man, and he hits him in stride. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play.
Pierce.
And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. A 3-yard loss. Fourth down now. The Texans going to signal for their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. The kick by Fairbairn is good. And they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3.
So, Charles, they get to them with their first turnover of the game and then make it hurt a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball up, what's the first thing a coach tells his defense? Don't let them score off of this. You've got to put out the fire. In fact, in 2021, that's what one NFL coach turned his defense. The firemen, go out there, guys, and don't let them put some points on the board.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Charles, he doesn't seem to be particularly in tune with his receivers, just 2 for 7 throwing the football, but he did seem really locked in before the game.
Yeah, and that has to do with receivers sometimes. Sometimes the defense.
And this is caught at the 20! So we have reached halftime here in an 11-point contest. As we'll get you down the coast,
well, we'll move right through the break then, skipping halftime and back to the field for the start of the second half.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter.
And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
And wriggled down quickly just past the 40 at the 41. Young looks to throw on first down.
Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
Well, the great coach has said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
And Young's throw there incomplete.
The good signal calls would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game, because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans' 34-yard line. Now here's Young.
He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
Throw left side is complete on the diving effort. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans' 13-yard line. Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. From the red zone now, Young. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up. Jimmy Ward, and the Texans are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And they just got a little help from their defense, forcing the turnover. Now can they make that payoff in points?
They need to, partner. They're down on the scoreboard. Need to take advantage of those opportunities, and this is a good one right in front of them.
Stroud looking to throw. And that's off the mark, incomplete.
Well, they certainly aren't letting up today, partner, because they've forced big turnovers already, and it's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
Stroud on third down now. He's got his target. That's complete. And he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Pierce now up the middle. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. Well, the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well. He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
And now off to the races, down the right side. And he's going to be shoved out, but not before he gets this down to the 20-yard line. He had his sights on the end zone, no doubt, but is brought down after a huge return there. And they'll have a short field to go as this drive starts on the fringe of the red zone at the 20. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 68 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot. Hands it off out of the gun. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Panthers are able to stretch out their lead. Prater for the extra point, and the lead is up to 18 now. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. Here comes Darius Phillips out of the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. And now out comes Houston.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
On second down, here's Pierce. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. 15 yards, the Texans pick up the first down. And the Texans first down. Another carry for Pierce. We'll get this up to the 47 and brought down there.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. This is the National Football League on EA Sports.
Ready.
Stroud now on second down. Short throw into the hands of Jordan.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. First target, first catch, and a first down.
A shotgun snap to Stroud.
And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
Back to throw. Here's Stroud. And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 28.
First and 10, it's Pierce.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage.
The time called here because a member of the Texans is in some discomfort. Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment.
About 3 yards there to the 27.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety of being able to hit people with the run in the pass, but in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit, but you're right, it might go to
they intercept Stroud again, the third time in this game. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And the Panthers are going to take possession here at their own 6-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And good job of just fighting through one tackle there to pick up about 3. Second down coming up.
They'll come up 2nd and 7.
They'll keep it on the ground. Peoples slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage.
Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard. They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down.
On 3rd down, Peoples. And they'll get him down up past the 15.
We'll get a pause here. There appears to be a Panther who was shaken up on that last play.
So a little breathing room now. 1st and 10 at the 17. Up the middle they go. Peoples. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down.
So from the 26-yard line, here's 2nd down and 2.
Now a handoff up the middle. Peoples, and he's taken down but able to slip across the 35.
110 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
All runs on this drive so far. It's 1st and 10. Up the middle they go. Peoples. And that one goes for about 6 as he's taken down just shy of the 45. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Ready?
On 2nd down, Peoples. And for one of the few times here today, okay, this run's ready. Not going to go anywhere. This will be the 8th play of the drive here, 3rd and 4. Now a handoff up the middle, Peoples. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on 3rd.
Hand cycle.
And Young's going to throw it here. And he's going to go down. The Texans come at him and able to bring him to the ground.
Will Anderson able to record his fifth sack of the season.
So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Meanwhile, the throw by Young was knocked away and incomplete.
Well, partner, guaranteed they approached this play with the idea of making up ground to make third down manageable. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
Meanwhile, the throw by Young was knocked away and incomplete. So two third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with fourth down. Yeah, yikes, terrible kick headed straight for the sidelines. And where will this be spotted? The side judge says it went out just across midfield.
Houston set to take over. They were coming off the extra week of rest, but this team started sluggish and it really didn't get any better from there, and trailing big here in this fourth quarter.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Stroud's throw taken in by Collins.
Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter.
Meanwhile, Stroud's throw complete into the hands of Schultz here.
Now the Texans will use one of their two remaining timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Oh, what a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this.
The throwing again is Stroud.
Got his man complete over the middle. That's Pierce. The Texans going to signal for their third and final timeout. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside.
Stroud working out of the gun.
And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Dalton Schultz, his first touchdown on the year.
And the Texans are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter.
Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And it makes the score 21-10. So time definitely not in their favor. Down two scores, but they'll try the onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. And they just took a timeout with 2 seconds to go. This one obviously decided. Not sure they needed to take it, but we'll take it with them. And the kick is good. So you wonder how this one might be remembered the next time these two teams meet. But until then, this game's over.
I should have served a little one, but he right back for another one. Quarter on the quarter, how you double up? Right off the bus, soon as he touched down, run the money up. One, one, one. Water, a little vinegar mix, it's tough enough, take another.